There are a lot of considerations when you're trying to build a website, especially e-commerce website. Let's first start looking at e-commerce business considerations. There are at least 6 different challenges and potentially more. Number one challenge is, what are you trying to sell? And what is the value of the product that you will be selling? Based on what you sell, it will determine if customers will come and buy it. So what you need to understand here is the very important part. What kind of value are you trying to deliver to your customers? How are you different from your competition? Another big question you might be asking yourself is, how are you planning to build this website? Certainly, you can do custom development of the website, but much better options is maybe to use pre-built packages. One good package, for example, is WordPress, which uses WooCommerce as the e-commerce store. Certainly worth exploring because it provides a lot of automation and free out-of-the-box features, since the only thing you need to pay for is the hosting. What is the biggest risk of launching an e-commerce web store? From my standpoint, the biggest risk is, what if you launch it and they will not come? And I'm talking here about customers. How can you mitigate this risk and make sure that this doesn't happen? The best way to mitigate this risk is maybe do a proof of concept. Considering this risk, you might also decide to see, how can you market this particular product? What is your role to the market? And what I mean here is, where are you going to get this product if this is a physical product? Where are you going to store it? How are you going to deliver it to the customer? It makes it much easier if this is a digital product. Considering what are you planning to sell makes it an extremely important part of the equation. Because based on that, you would need to decide your storage facility as well as the go-to-market strategy. And last but not least thing is to look at the competition. To mitigate the main risk of launching the site and customers not showing up at your e-commerce store door, you need to look at the competition. Is competition offering something similar than what you're selling? Or maybe there is no competition, which could be good, but at the same time, it could be bad also, because you might be introducing a new type of product that doesn't exist on the market. Now let's look at the technological challenges of building the e-commerce store. The main challenge is, what type of technology are you planning to use? For example, in my e-commerce store, I use WordPress technology, and I'm currently using eBook Store plugin for that. But this is probably not the best choice. I'm still in process of researching what the choices are, and I have a lot of candidates that I would like to consider before switching to a different product, because I already have an established process to sell digital products. When I am selecting WordPress plugin for my e-commerce store, I look at the features and capabilities. For example, how well is store integrated with main payment systems like PayPal or Stripe? Another important consideration for me is, would digital product be delivered automatically to the customer? Will they get a confirmation email? Another big part of the equation is the cost. Is there a one-time cost to get this plugin? Or is there an ongoing cost that you need to pay to the vendor annually? Another big part of the technological equation is, how complex it is to build an e-commerce site. How much technical knowledge do you need to have? How easy it is to customize? Those are the questions in my mind that I keep asking myself to make sure that whatever I pick, I will be able to use to deliver quality product. When you're building the e-commerce site, you also need to consider marketing aspect of this. Are you the one that will be doing marketing of the website? Or do you have access or planning to hire a team of professionals who can help you the market? The challenge is that your e-commerce store will have a URL, but how would customers know that they need to come to this URL and buy those excellent products that you're planning to sell? To accomplish this goal, you need to build a marketing strategy. You need to have a good understanding of how you're planning to share this link with the customers. How are you planning to market your e-commerce store to make sure that they come and they actually have a chance to see your store in the first place before even purchasing? Another important consideration of building e-commerce store is testing and deployment. Let me share with you some additional details that you might find beneficial. For example, e-commerce store is not just a static store. Customers are expected to add items to cart, they're expected to check out, and they're expected to receive those products that they purchased. How are you planning to do this? At the minimum, you at least need to test this chain once to make sure that you as a user can come in, add products to cart, check out, make sure your payment will get processed, and then you as a test user receive the product that was promised to the customer. Compatibility is also an extremely important part. Do you have any other e-commerce stores in place that you're trying to migrate to the new platform? Or are you building from scratch? Building it from scratch makes it easier, but only from technology standpoint. If this is the first time that you're building e-commerce store, it means that you need to spend heavier resources on marketing. But if you have an existing e-commerce store, you need to understand how are you going to migrate your existing customers into the new store. You're most likely accounting for existing customers to come in and potentially do repeated purchases on your website. And last but not least technical consideration is how are you planning to support, maintain, and upgrade e-commerce store in the new platform. Ideally, you might want to learn from what customers are ordering, which features of the platform are useful, and then keep ongoingly enhancing your website to make sure customers are getting new features and capabilities going forward. You also need to build a process to understand what if you received an email from the customer and what to do with this email. The email could be for the item that maybe never was received. What do you do in this case? The email also might be a request for refund. There are a lot of different reasons why a customer may decide to contact you, and you need to have a process to respond to all of these types of inquiries. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this video was helpful and helped you to solve your challenge. If you like the content, please give this video a big thumbs up. This tells us that you need more content like this, and we will make sure to deliver it to you in the future. Also, please make sure to check out our free and premium resources on the website. All you need to do is to go to the menu section and select appropriate options. In addition, make sure you don't forget to look at the downloads in the description section of this video. I also recommend that you follow Online Training for Everyone. We are constantly delivering new content to help you solve different problems and challenges. And I also have a favor to ask. If you know someone who would benefit from this content, please make sure to share this video with your friends or colleagues to help them solve their challenges. Make sure to leave your questions or suggestions in the comment section of this video. And all the best on your journey. Thanks for watching.